With the AI step element, you can incorporate AI into your chatbot flows to branch them based on user actions or goal completion and save data for personalized responses. Go to the flow builder and add the AI step element. You can place it anywhere in your flow, including the start, the middle, or the end. In the instruction for the bot field, enter a prompt outlining your company, products, or services. Define the response format and include examples of popular questions and desired answers. You can also add variables to personalize messages. Your prompt can include business specifics, limitations, and communication style. You can instruct the AI to analyze customer intent and preferences and offer different options based on their responses. This will make chatbot interactions personalized and drive more results. In the step type field, select an element execution mode. Relevant settings will appear based on your selected type. One-time execution. This mode is suitable for simple flows where your chatbot needs to generate and send a response immediately. For instance, it can calculate an expression or translate a piece of text. In the execution behavior field, select one of the following actions. Send a reply from AI to the subscriber as a message. Use this action to respond as soon as the user reaches this element. Continue the chain without a response. Use this action to pass data to the next element. You can process the user's response and add it to your next message element using the shortcode. Conditional exit. This mode makes your chatbot wait until a specific goal is achieved within a set time frame before the user exits the element and continues down the flow. If another chatbot trigger is activated, the user will exit the AI step element and the AI will stop waiting for a response. In the When Entering the Element field, decide when to activate the AI. The AI bot writes first. Use this option to initiate chatbot conversations immediately, for example, to send a welcome message or offer to take a test. Waiting for incoming message. Use this option to make your chatbot wait for the first user message. This can help process requests or gather more information before starting an interaction. In the Set Goals as Exit Conditions field, define what constitutes a completed goal for the user to move to the next flow element. You can also add variables to create a dynamic goal. Every user will have a unique value based on variables available at the time they reach the AI step element. This way, you can determine user needs and purchases they are ready to make. These goals help the AI understand user intent and offer relevant solutions. To avoid false triggers, it's essential to use clear and specific data collection conditions and criteria. General and vague descriptions can lead to errors in the flow execution. Clear: when the user shares a phone number in international format or their phone number is already known. Vague: phone number received. Condition and variable description clarity determine your flow accuracy, so take the time to write them out and minimize the risk of false triggers. To make your chatbot save specific user data to a variable, click Save User Response Data. In the first field, define the data to be retrieved from the user's response. In the second field, select a variable from your chatbot audience. When selecting variables, be mindful of their types. To save numbers that may need future updates, use the number variable type. To record dates, select date, and for text data, use string. Data will be automatically converted based on your variable's data type. In the Stay in Element Maximum field, set the time during which the element should remain active. Suppose you set it to 1 hour and the user sends their first message after 59 minutes. In this case, they will exit the AI step element after 1 minute, and their next messages will no longer be processed by it. In the Execution Behavior field, select one of the following actions. Send a reply from AI to the subscriber as a message. Use this action to respond as soon as the user reaches this element. Continue the chain without a response. Use this action to pass data to the next element. You can process the user's response and add it to your next message element using the shortcode. To customize the AI model, click its name in the upper right corner and fill in the following fields. OpenAI token. Decide how to authorize requests. Inherit the token from your settings or use a dedicated token for this chatbot. Model. Select an AI model to generate responses. Conversation context size. Specify the number of previous messages the AI should consider when generating a response. Maximum number of tokens in response. Specify the number of tokens your chatbot can use for a single response. Temperature. Adjust response creativity. The higher the value, the more creative the response. After filling in all the fields, click Save. After filling in all the fields, click Apply to save your settings. Continue your flow. Branch your flow using exit points to adapt it to user actions and make chatbot interactions more natural. If the AI step element reaches its goal, use the green exit point to continue your flow. If the waiting time expires and the user does not complete the target action, they will automatically reach the red exit point. This allows you to properly move on from the current step or send a notification to re-engage the user. Flow branching helps your chatbot account for user actions and adjust your flow to the conversation context. Next, add elements to every flow branch. Optionally, add another AI step element to clarify the user's queries or offer multiple options based on their request. You can also send an API request or integrate with Google Sheets to check product availability or status. Use variables to add external data points to your prompts and deliver them to users seamlessly. To see your flow in action, click Save and send to yourself in the upper right corner of the builder. To share your flow, exit the builder, click the three dots under your flow name, and select Link to launch a flow. To track subscribers who have exited or are still in the AI step element, switch to Flow View mode and click the number at the bottom of the element.